flowers. So two flowers and a bunch of leaves and another flower. So this flower is face on, so it looks circular. These are more oval in shape. So I would use this aid to draw in. So there's a couple of ovals here. And so this one is another oval. All right, so that helps me to. Okay, so that we again mix the color, blue, red. So get rid of most of the water here, and then so this the blood brush mostly purple, and then the tip you would have some blue. So I'm gonna losing some of this thing here, so maybe. So the stroke like this, you take color again, and you have that. Now you can barely see the oval now, but this is a like that. And then you finish it off by two more strokes like that. So then you can finish off two strokes like this. That's not too bad. So now then this one again, I can see the oval much better. So. First, I'll start off with that, so you can see the watermark, like this, and then a couple more strokes, and then two strokes, so it gives you that. So I think we'll do this one also, so this one is going down here somewhere. So this is like a circle now, so I think it's easier to visualize a circle than an oval. Okay, okay, and then we'll do the flowering bud. The flowering bud just a drag, probably needs a little bit more blue. You should wash the brush more often. You get better effect. You can wash the brush, take the purple and then the blue. And then so here. So you can just kind of drag. So the brush point this way with the pointy tip. You can just kind of drag with two strokes possible. Or whatever, however many it takes to give you the shape. So let's say two strokes. And then to make sure they're not all lined up. Some regular fashion, so that these two are spaced out like this. So the third one should be spaced closer, and then it should be. Then it should. Let's say I put it over here. Then we line up with this guy. So I put it further, a little further down, so it doesn't line up with anybody. Mm-hmm. So something like that. And then again, we'll use the black. It says black. Okay, now we're ready for. Okay, this one doesn't have it. Okay. And then you can connect it to some kind of connection with a lighter color. Okay, so now the next thing is the leaves. Oh, okay, well now actually they're drying a bit. So actually now we can actually proceed with the yellow. So pretty light color, it's a pretty dilute color is typically what we need. So the key here, one nice suggestion is you just dot them in rather than paint it in. Paint in, then it gets into the other colors. You just dot it in and it just stays where you have dotted, like this. Okay, so we're in good shape here. So now we'll do the leaves is the next thing. Take the very black ink and spread it out over here. So my brush is already a little bit with the. Alright, okay, we probably should wash it. It's not from scratch, so let's see here. So then now we have loaded with this this color. And the tip, you take the darker color, and the very tip, maybe even darker. still. So we now we go, so there's one leaves here, so boom, boom, boom. And then this one here. So keep taking ink, so then we will look different. So then, three few strokes together like this, few strokes like that. So, alright, so we're ready for the, in the notes actually I said that I should mix the yellow with the black, which I did not do, but this is also possible just using the gray. So now we start for the vine, so it comes down like this, and you can kind of form some kind of a network. I see you have another one coming in. So there's kind of a net here. And then here you connect here another more, another net. Here more net. Here, then you start doing the curls. So begin a nice coin, and then you just go curl like that, the dots, and then some zigzag somewhere. So let's say some zigzag here, maybe some zigzag here as well. Okay, so now this corner is too empty, so now we have to draw some more lines down here and then create another leaves here. Right, so that's that. Then we connect these to the rest of it. Okay, and then the finally would be the dots. Take some pretty darkening, and then usually a little dots helps a lot. So the dot just kisses the stem. Okay, that's good. So now we can put it in the center. Flower. So I think that using the blue is good, I thought. You can use the ink, but I think the blue is good, so you just take the most intense blue. So little dashes and dots. It's supposed to, I think there's some kind of thing shooting out from the center of the trumpet for these flowers. So you really are not drawing that, but it gives you some idea of that. Yeah, I think so that's
good.
Pretty close.
Mine, that doesn't come out like that.
Okay, and then this one.
Okay.
So beautiful. Okay, do you want to draw the wing?
Oh, okay, we can draw the wing, okay. Okay, so we use the this brush here. Okay. So bring you have to have a very dry brush. The way to do that is just squeeze it with a paper towel. So very dry. Now you take the ink. You can even just scrape off the dry. So sometimes the ink gets dried here. So you just scrape it off on the dry part. It's very dry. So you can touch it by feel. You can know how wet it is by touching it. Then, and then you can just see there's already some streaks here. So you have to take a look at it first, and then figure out what will help the leaves from the or from what is already there. So you can do that. Well, sometimes you don't really need to button this. So that one here. And I can see there is a dark part here and a light part here. So this way we'll have to center vein, two, and then the rest like that. And then this one, maybe just a couple of strokes. Maybe some dots sometimes. You don't have to. It needs to be quite irregular and free for this kind of stuff. And you don't want to draw every vein in. That would be too. This is a very kind of a loose type of picture. So if you draw all the lines in, it doesn't look good. So you only draw some of it in. So just a suggestion. Yeah.
Okay. And that's it. So, yeah. Yeah, that looks nice.
Okay, Sam, your turn.